Samsung decided to roll out Galaxy S24 with two different chipsets, Snapdragon for North America and Exynos for the rest of us. I have the S24 Exynos version with me on the left side and the S23 Snapdragon on the right. Today I will answer whether the speed, performance and battery life of the S24 Exynos compared to the S23 in the real life. Let's start by speed testing. I used both phones for a few days and my personal experience is that the battery life and speed are very close, but we should do proper testing to know this for sure. Galaxy S24 has 0.1 inch larger display, has 100 mAh larger battery, a 1.5 times larger vapor chamber for cooling the device, and has adaptive refresh rate, which means the refresh rate of the displays can go down to zero. So in theory, it should last longer, and since it has the latest Exynos 2400 against the last generation of a Snapdragon, which is a Snapdragon 8 Generation 2, the performance should also be much better. One thing I want to mention right away is that the Galaxy S24 Exynos 2400 doesn't support Wi-Fi 7. Wi-Fi 7 is faster than Wi-Fi 5. Right now both phones are connected to Wi-Fi. I will turn off the Wi-Fi connection soon and will connect them to the 5G network. I am Mo, and you may already know that I'm kind of a scientist myself. I did my doctoral degree in computer science at NTU in Singapore, and in science, we have something called A-B testing. So what you do is first you want to lay out a hypothesis, and then you control the environment, and with A-B testing, you check if your hypothesis is correct. Therefore, I created a hypothesis that the S24 Exynos battery lasts longer compared to the S23. Another hypothesis that I have is that S24 Exynos also performs better than S23 in most of use cases. To test both of them, I do a through real-life battery and performance test with both of them, which will take me a full day. In the end, we'll all know whether my hypothesis is correct or S23 will surprise us. So grab your popcorn and let's get into it. The room temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, which is 77 Fahrenheit. I made sure both phones had the same brightness level and I set it manually. Both phones are running Wi-Fi in the beginning and then will connect to 5G after the YouTube test. Both have the same application set and setting and are 1 week old and the battery is already calibrated. So as you saw, most of the time Galaxy S24 is faster than S23. There is just one exception. When I run Adobe Premiere Rush, it took S24 much longer to export the 4K video compared to the S23. That is not a big issue since it could be the case that Adobe Premiere Rush is not optimized for S24 Exynos. What worries me a lot after doing all the tests is the fact that the body temperature of S24 is 2 degrees higher than S23. The problem is the heat degrades the longevity of the battery and other parts of the phone. And the test that I ran was just running daily applications and light game. For the next test, I ran a YouTube short in a loop to see how much the battery drains. One thing you may notice is colors of these two displays are very different. The tone in S24 is milder, but S23 is sharper and more vivid. It kind of depends which one you prefer yourself. At the end of the test, S24 had 1% less battery and also was 1 degree warmer than S23. The interesting thing is that the battery temperature of S24 was cooler, which is most likely due to a larger vapor chamber. I also checked the temperature of the back of the phone and the Galaxy S24 was again a degree higher than S23. Now both phones are at 92% and I'm gonna go for an hour's walk. I will track my walk in three parts. It's a Strava, Adidas running, and the Galaxy Health app itself. And we will see which phone loses more battery. While I am in Vienna and the weather is a little bit windy, it would be lovely if you like the video and subscribe to the channel. It means a lot to me. I'm almost at 1,000 subscribers. This close to get to the goal. So let's see what the result tells us about the GPS tracking. I am back and both phones are at 77%. The route that I took doesn't always have a good signal and the GPS was always on. There is a fear that with a bad signal, Exynos loses more battery. At least that is not what I experienced. A huge extra point to S24 because the GPS accuracy was much better. I compared my activity to the activity that I track with my Garmin watch, and it is much more comparable to it. For example, S23 says my max speed is 8.3 km per hour, which is 5.1 miles per hour. That is a running speed and is not accurate at all. S24 says it is 6.6 km per hour, which is 4.1 miles per hour and is closer to reality. Next, I ran the camera on 4K and 60 frames per second. In the middle of the test, the S24 camera stopped to work. I assume it is due to overheating, but I cannot confirm it. That was around the 20 minutes mark. I restarted the test after. Again, the same story. The body temperature of S23 is 1 degree lower, but the battery temperature is 1 degree higher than S24. Then I left the phone with the screen on for half an hour. And to my surprise, S24 lost less battery. Now S24 is 56% and S23 is 55%. Let's move to benchmarks. First, I ran Geekbench CPU test. Galaxy S24 got 25% better results in multi-core. The single core was very close. Then I ran the GPU test and Galaxy S24 dominated this time. It got a 70% better result, which is crazy. Now we are at 49% battery for both phones. They are going shoulder to shoulder. Then I ran a wildlife extreme test. It is a 20 minutes test to test the gaming performance of the device under heavy use. One thing I should mention though is when I was studying chipset design back in university, the professor who was working in the famous chipset manufacturer told us that lots of companies optimize the chipsets to run better for famous benchmarks. So don't take the results always too seriously and don't get hung up on them. Both phones are burning by the end of the test and it's not easy to grab them. Honestly, I kind of feel bad for them. They are 42 degrees Celsius, which is 108 degrees Fahrenheit. From my personal experience, this is as hot as the phone gets because higher than that, the CPU starts to throttle, or in case of the camera, it just stops to work. The result was better on S24, but only slightly. S24 also used 1% more battery during the test. One important thing that I noticed is S24 Exynos gets cooler much faster than the S23, mostly because of a larger vapor chamber. Just after a few minutes, the S24 battery temperature was 6 degrees lower than the S23. Now S24 is 29% battery and S23 is at 30. Next, I played Genshin Impact for 10 minutes on each phone. Genshin Impact is a very demanding game and I put the setting to the maximum for both phones. Both handled 60 frames per second well in the beginning, but struggled and throttled a bit towards the end. The body temperature of S24 is 3 degrees higher than S23. That's a lot of degrees. The only place the thermal of the S24 is better was during the Geekbench test. Now S23 is completely ahead, with 16% battery left compared to 12% of S24. To finish the batteries, I play YouTube Shorts and YouTube 4K videos. It is getting really exciting. Can S23 outperform S24 in terms of battery life? Seems like it. Oh my god, oh my god, S23, you did it, you son of a boy, you did it. You know, even though I did bet on S24 in the beginning, at the end of the test, I was standing on my feet watching the last percentage of S24 go down to zero, and I was cheering for S23 to hang in there. S23 was the underdog and surprised me, so let's say it again, a phone with 100 mAh more battery and a 1.5 times larger vapor chamber lost to a phone from the last generation. I will just leave it at that. I don't know what to say. I wanted Exynos to win. Not long ago, Exynos was the better chipset. Maybe some of you remember those days. To be fair to Exynos, the only place that it used more battery was Genshin Impact, but maybe the game is very poorly optimized for Exynos. Also, 5% can be simply a margin of error, and maybe if you run the same scenario, Galaxy S24 wins next time. So my verdict is both phones have almost the same battery, the S24 Exynos performance is better in most use cases and benchmarks, but to me it looks like it heats more than S23. On the other hand, it also cools down faster. You know, I kind of understand the decision that Samsung executives made. You cannot just shut down your chipset factory. They probably made a strategic decision and they knew the risk, but went ahead with it anyways. So it is official, my first hypothesis was wrong. S24 Exynos did not last as long as S23 Snapdragon in this specific test that I have done. Maybe in another test you get different results. My second hypothesis was almost right. S24 performance is much better in almost all use cases. If you enjoyed this video, I did a thorough comparison of the camera of these two phones. So go ahead and click on the video that is popping up right now. Let me know what you think about the difference between these two phones. Thanks for tuning into Tecmo, and until the next one, bye.